Okay guys, have a 2006 Odyssey. We're swapping the transmission. The truck has been diagnosed by the dealer. The guy didn't want to spend $4,500 on a new one, so he bought a Japanese imported one. And we want to swap it. And the first thing we're gonna do is that we wanna come down here, and to drain the fluid, you can either just go in here with a 3/8 ratchet, take the bolt off, the fluid is gonna come off there. But so that you're doing a fluid change, but we wanna do it. We're gonna extract all the fluid. So, since we're swapping the transmission for that, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna remove these holes right here. It's the closer one. And I'm gonna, after I remove it, I'm gonna put a container under, and I'm gonna crank the van and see if that's my line for that fits the fluid to the cooler. If that's the one that fits hose, not the return. We need to find the fit hose, not the return. If that's the case, then you just crank the van, leave it on, don't move it from park, and all the fluid is gonna come to there. So I'm gonna pull the hose out, and I'll be right, and then I'll show you how to do it. Okay guys, I removed the hose from there. And when you do a flush and you want to remove all the fluid from those transmissions, I'm gonna pretend we're doing a flush, but the dealer don't recommend a flush, just to, because the transmission has it takes about seven and a half quarts of transmission fluid. So you want to do a flush, you do that, you do this. I'm gonna pretend I'm doing a flush, but if not, just draining the about three and a half quarts. That'll be enough. As you can see, I have the hose here. So I'm gonna pretend we're doing a flush, so you kind of know what I'm doing. And nothing is gonna happen to your transmission if you do this, but you need to know how to do it. So I'm gonna do it, hopefully you guys can see. Okay, start the car. Make sure it's in park. What?
Can I put the key in the ignition?
Yeah, turn it on. So hopefully you guys can see. If we were doing a flush, this is what will happen. Turn it on. See how the fluid is running there? Hope you guys can see that. There. If you were to do a flush, this is what you do. That means that's our fit. That's the line that fits the fluid. Turn it off! Okay, on. See how more fluid comes. If you were doing a flush, guys, you guys do this. As long as you don't move your transmission from the parking setting, you won't have any problems. That noise that we heard is the timing belt tensioner. Once the van heats up, it goes away. So I'm gonna drain this one more time. On. And if you're doing a flush, guys, that's what you guys do. Okay, I'm gonna let it drain. If you're doing a flush, that's what you do. Stop the car, then go, and then stop, and then go. Okay. But if you're only doing the drain, you just drain from the plug there. Okay. You can see how the fluid keeps on coming out. Okay, guys, we're doing a flush at this point. You will guys have to stop and then just put the hose back and refill the, turn the current off, you know, put the hose back and fill the, fill your transmission again with about 7.8 quarts. So that should, that's how you do a flush on those Hondas. So, but we're draining it because we're swapping the transmission, so no more fluids there. So I'm gonna stop there. Okay, so next thing we do, I remove the battery. I'm gonna take this sensor connector off. I'm gonna loosen that, this, and then another bolt right here, so we can remove this box. Remove this. We're gonna get another size 10 bolt here. That one, and then one size 12 over here. And then this one on this side, you just loosen it a little bit. And over here, and you guys can see there's another bolt here. Since you're gonna remove that transmission, you're gonna have to remove the fender cover. So I already did, and I loosened the bolt from down there. Then this, you just slide it out like that. Okay, so now we're gonna start removing those clips. There. And there, this one. And that way we can get to the starter. The starter is gonna have this connector here. You just pull it out. Then over here you're gonna have a size 12 nut. Remember, anything that you take off, try to put it back. So you won't lose it. And okay, we're gonna disconnect those things here so we won't damage them, because they're part of the harness that comes on top of the transmission. So I'm gonna do that so we can remove this radiator hose. So I'm gonna do that. Okay, so got those pliers, pretty handy. Craftsman 41838. Let's start to play around with the hoses that are pretty stuck. There we go. It won't damage the hose. You already have a container there, ready for the antifreeze. Let's just remove it. So we're gonna disconnect the throttle as well. Then for this connector here, sometimes it has a little tab here, just poke to it, or you can just push it back there. You can see it's loose. So now that you have space, you just come in and disconnect everything that you see here. So you wanna do that, we'll start disconnecting all the sensors that we can. And I'm gonna do that, guys. Just disconnect everything, the harness, everything, this connector, so we can just pull this back. And this one goes all the way to the front, so I'm gonna do that. Just disconnect all of that. Now I'm gonna, before I disconnect the bottom ones, I'm gonna take off the starter for this one here. Just have a little tap there. Just push on the tap and it should pop right out. Just like that. And then the starter has this 17 bolt there. Then another one on the bottom. If those things are on your way, you can just push it up a little bit and then loosen up that bolt there on the bottom as well. Okay, so I got the bolt from the starter on the bottom. I already loosened it. It's actually pretty much on the front of the starter, so those are not actually on your way. You get that one. So I'm removing the bolt from the bottom for the starter. I believe I got it already. Yeah. a long one, and then this one on top. And that's how we're gonna remove the starter, guys. As you can see, it's pretty much loose, so I'm just gonna remove the bolt. We got the starter. Don't forget to put your bolts with the starter, whatever you wanna seat the starter on. So, okay, guys, over here is just the same. Disconnect the sensor. And we have a ground here that goes for the battery. Don't forget that ground is very important. Your car will not start if you don't put it back. So we're just gonna keep on disconnecting all the sensors until we can pull the big harness back, okay? So I'm gonna do that. Okay, guys, this one had a clip here. Another important thing, right here on by this connector, we're still gonna disconnect the one on the bottom, but right here, you see this one right here, it's a size 10 right there, and that's the ground from the computer for that fits the where the computer gets ground. So very important, if you're not gonna remember that, you can just mark it right here, it's a size 10 by the connector. All we have to do is just disconnect the sensors on the bottom, and then we could just pull the harness back. Okay, so this is the sensor that I told you about, it that has the ground there. So this one here has a little top on the bottom, you just kind of push it down, that way you can just disconnect it there. This is the ground that I told you guys. That ground goes to the computer, so very, very important that you remember this one. You can just mark it, tape it, whatever you want to do. Now, we're also going to remove this here. And that's to disconnect the neutral switch. There we go. So, we can pull the harness now. Okay, guys, just to let you know that I almost forgot to tell you, I wasn't gonna forget because I had no way to pull this. Here's another sensor there. A couple times I always forgot to plug that sensor back, so make sure it's a temperature sensor. Make sure you plug it back. And here's another ground right here from the computer. So, like I said, you're gonna remember this. Tape them. Tape them or mark them. Okay, guys, I forgot to mention, you don't want to disconnect all those that go to the neutral switch and all that. You can just disconnect it from here and those will stay there, and then you can just pull that. The reason that I did it is because the other transmission, I saw that two of the connectors were damaged, so that's why I didn't just unplug it from here, from this main connector. That's the reason that I unplug it from there. But other than that, then we can just disconnect those big connectors there on the back, all the sensors here. So just make sure you free this wire. Once you free this wire, you're gonna start seeing how everything is pretty, it's gonna turn easy. Okay, so don't forget to disconnect those on the back also. Okay, so we'll do that. Okay, I'm gonna disconnect this sensor here. I'm also gonna remove the bolt here, but just haven't done it. But 1, 2, 3 bolts, so I can just move that around. Now disconnect this one here. For this big connector, it has a tab there, and it goes there on that bracket. So you just push it down and pull it. And that's how you will remove it from the bracket. So. Now, as we can see, we can pull our harness to the side. There we go. Got another bracket there. So now we can see the bolts that are holding the transmission against the attached to the motor. It's one here, another one here. There's two or three. So I'm gonna loosen up this ABS pump. So okay, so we have two bolts holding the attaching the transmission. Before we start working on the bottom, make sure you break those loose, because if not, they might give you some trouble later. So they're still pretty much inside. I just gave them maybe two or three turns to loosen them up. So then we're gonna go on the bottom, guys. Okay, you're gonna come to the tie rod. I already removed the clip and the knot. It's a size 19. After that, you just hit it there hard until it pops out. Okay, once it pops out, we're gonna do the same to the ball joint. The ball joint has this clip that it attached to the nut like this. All you do is you just open it here with the screwdriver and pull back, and it should do it. So I'm gonna do that. Before we go any further, we need to look at the clip sensor. Make sure we don't damage it. Like I said, guys, try to put everything, all the little bolts that you remove them, try to put them back there. So I also remove a size 12 bolt from the brake line. So now we're gonna do the ball joint here. We're gonna do the ball joint. So I'm gonna loosen it up. To remove the ball joint, I'm gonna use this crescent wrench, and I'm gonna put the tie rod back, or you can loosen up the ball joint before you remove the tie rod. If not, you just put it back there and hold it, and put the wrench there. Hold the tie rod and break it loose. Okay. After you get that, you just put the bolt for the tie rod there, for the ball joint. I'm sorry, but don't take it off all the way, guys. That's for safety. We're gonna hit it here with the hammer until it comes loose as well. But before that, we're gonna loosen this nut right here with the big impact. Okay. You can remove this bolt before you try to remove the tire rod and everything. So whatever you want to do there. Okay, so we're hitting the ball joint there, and then you just walk it there. Once you see it moves like that, that means it's loose. So now you can remove the nut there, then hold it, and you can just remove that there to the side. Now we can remove the axle. After that, you just remove the axle, guys, and that should do it. Okay, so we're here on the transmission, so we're just gonna pop the axles out. We're gonna use a chisel. So if you can wear your glasses, see where the axle is right there. You can just put a screwdriver there and push it or hammer it, whatever you can do. It's better if someone helps you and holds the axle on the other end. So I'm gonna do that there. Also here, I'm gonna put this screwdriver there and hit it like that so I can push it out. So I'm gonna do that, guys. If you guys have trouble, but there's a lot of videos on how to remove the axles. So I'm gonna pop the axles out. Okay, so next up we're gonna remove the flex pipe with the cat. Not the cat, with the flex pipe. For these guys, it's a socket 14. This wasn't as hard, but the one they attached to the cat over there, those right there, those were pretty hard, guys. So I had to use the big Milwaukee impact, and with a swivel station, so you're probably gonna have a hard time, even though I did put some brake loose lubricant last night on all bolts, but those were pretty hard, guys. I couldn't break them loose with the breaker bar, so you're really gonna need an impact there. Over here then you have three, then on the front another three, and those three there, and then the flex pipe should come right off, okay? So you guys can see the flex pipe is almost off. I'm gonna remove this bracket here. It's two size 14 bolts as well. So once you remove that, this thing pretty much comes loose. So it's the bracket there. So it's two bolts. You can see that I already removed one there. So I'm gonna remove that and remove the flex pipe. Okay guys, now we're gonna start removing the shifter cable. So you're gonna remove this size 10, then this size 12, but to start you need to remove the size 10 first. That there, so it gives you, that's actually gonna be two, one on the top as well, right there. And that's what's gonna give you the space to unbolt those 1, 2, 3 size 12 bolts, okay?
Yeah.
Okay, after you remove these three size 12 bolts, you just, this one hooks in there like that. So you need to wiggle this part right here. After that, we have that shifter cable here. But also before that, we need to remove the this cover for the for the flywheel. So, that one. And this one, and the cover should pop just right out there. So here's the important thing, guys. So we're gonna remove about 6 or 8 of this size 10 bolts right here. Those are the ones that attach the turbine to the flywheel. So what you can do, if you're not sure, you can just mark this bolt right here, and so have someone turn that engine with the 19 socket over there on the front, and as they turn it, they're gonna start appearing. You mark this one, so you know this is, once you get to this one, that's the one, that's gonna be your last one. So you can do that, but before that, I'm gonna remove the shifter cable here so I don't damage it, so I'll do that.
Yeah.
Okay, so for the shifter cable, it had those little tabs that block that size, that not the bolt, so it won't come loose. You just drive it through there. I believe it has 3 or 2, so there's the other one there. Once you have it there, sure. Don't lose the washer. This is the tabs that locks it. Once you put it, you install it, you just bend them, and that's it. And you just pull your shifter cable like that on the back there. So now what we're gonna do, we're gonna start removing those bolts here, size 10 as well. You don't have a ratchet or a little impact that fits there. Like I said, you can have someone hold the pulley, the crankshaft pulley, while you turn it with your wrench or ratchet. And this is basically what you do. It's gonna be like about 6 or 8 of them.
Okay. Yeah.
All right. So This is, if you have no one to help you, you get a screwdriver. And there's the flywheel right here. So what you do is that it depends on the rotation and the engine. So you can just start rotating the flywheel, your engine from here. And those bolts, try not to, what I do is all those bolts I always put in separate. I never mix it with the other bolts, so I know which ones are. So like I said, there you can see another one right there. So, and you're gonna keep on doing that until there's no more. So okay, so I'm gonna do that. Okay guys, so there was a total of 8 10 millimeter bolts. So, and the way that you know that the flywheel is free from the turbine is that you can actually turn the turbine and the plate won't move, see? So that's that, we know that the turbine is detached from the plate. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna remove these bolts here, so I can remove the axle. In reality, you don't need to, but all you have to do is unbolt the bracket here that holds this shaft to the engine. But we need to remove the shaft. You don't want to remove it, you just leave it there, but unbolt the bracket, and when you bring it, bring the transmission down, it's gonna come down with the axle and the shaft. So, but I'm gonna do that, I'm gonna remove this. Okay guys, so I'm gonna do that. Okay, so we're gonna remove this shield. It has three size 12 bolts, one here on top, and then the other one here on the other side. You can get it from the bottom. Okay, so I'm gonna remove those bolts and I'll show you the shield. See how it looks. Okay guys, I hope you guys can see that's the last bolt. I got the other one, it's on the other side. You can grab the other two from the bottom. We got that one there where the wrench is, it's size 12. So you can do it with a 1/4 inch ratchet and a socket, or you can just use one of those ratchets and wrenches, okay? Okay guys, I'm gonna remove the bracket from here. See how it came off? Like that, so you need to kind of turn it when you put it back. So there, now we need to remove this. It's a 14 and this one 14 or 13. There should be another one on the top, but it's not there. So we want to remove that, and then the bracket with the shaft, it will be that one, and then this one here. I need to remove this one. Yours might have another one here on top, so I'm gonna take those guys and I'm gonna remove the whole shaft. Okay, so I'm gonna do that. I'll show you guys already. That's enough, the bracket, the whole shaft. There is where the other bolt was, and here, so it's 3 bolts total. Now we have the whole shaft. I'm gonna remove it. When I go under, just wanted to show you, it's better if you just break it loose and then do with a, put your hand there, stick your hand there, and use a 1/4 inch ratchet with the 14 socket, size 14. So I'm gonna remove the whole shaft now, guys, okay? Just easy, just go in the bottom, if you have someone to help you. See, it's coming off smoothly. So, you guys can see that. Just came off. There we go. So there's the bolt. It has 112 here holding the shield. Then you're gonna have to remove this and that, and no, these little small ones, they hold the this small one, size 12. Those hold the shield that goes around it, and then your size 14 goes here and there. Once you remove those, you can remove actually the whole shafts, okay? So you guys saw that I removed the axle, the tie rod, and the speed sensor, and don't forget to remove this, the sway bar link. The owner didn't want to replace those suspension parts, are pretty beat up, but you know, just gonna do the transmission. Remove that because we want to drop the frame. In reality, it's easier. We're not even gonna disconnect the rack and pinion. I done this. It's easier just to drop the, once you secure everything, it's just way better to drop the frame. So I have, you know, I have seen some cars that they remove the rack and pinion and then they cannot get the alignment right on the truck. I mean, the truck will, the van will drive straight, but the steering column, the steering wheel will be will be pointing to one side, either right or left, and they cannot get them aligned. So I'm gonna do that, guys. So I'm gonna go on the bottom. I'm gonna show you what bolts to remove, but first, remember what you do: axle, tie rod, ball joint, and the sway bar link. You do that on both sides, okay? So, okay, guys, before we go under, I'm gonna show you a trick that I work with this guy who's a third generation mechanic, and he showed me that trick. As you can see, I have my cherry picker there, and I also, on this side, I have my bar. You know, for when I had to take out engines or transmissions, that goes on the hood, you know, and it holds the engine. But most of you guys don't not gonna have that because of that. So I'm gonna show you this trick. If you worry about your throttle, don't worry, nothing is gonna happen to it as long as you do it right. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna put a piece of twine here, make sure it's a strong one. We cut this board and we're gonna remove this size 10 bolt that holds the bracket there for the AC lines. Okay, we're gonna remove that. I can just leave it there. So next thing, you put this here, the board there, on that side there, and then on this side, right there, make sure it kind of aligns with the throttle. Make sure you're not on the computer. The power steering reservoir, I removed it. You just pull it out, pull it up a little bit, and it will come out of the rail. So you can do that. Okay, guys, as you can see, I went around it, the throttle. I unbolted the EVAP sensor. I forgot the name of it, but the solenoid. So you put it on the side, make sure it's not sitting on anything that is gonna break here either. You need to leave it a little play. Don't hold it all tight, you know, because we're gonna, the engine, in order for the transmission to come out, the engine has to tilt a little bit. So we're good there. And like I said, the way that I like to do those transmissions is I put a jack under here, and then I just hook the transmission to the cherry picker, move it to the side, drop it, easy. But a lot of guys are not gonna have that because they're DIY, that's how you say it. Then, you know, so you're trying to save money, and you're not gonna spend a lot of money on tools, so you can do this. So you can do this actually. I done this a lot of times. Even before, when we work in the shop, we will put the van on the four leak, and instead of having a jack, we will actually just put a rolling table under the transmission. We will just drop the transmission there on the rolling table, take it back into the whatever you want to fix it or build it or whatever. and we will just actually drop it on the table. We wouldn't drop it on the jack or the big transmission jack or anything. We will actually just drop it. This way, we had the truck on the leaf. It will just, you know, lower the van until it wasn't very far from the table. We'll just drop it there and lift the truck again and carry it. So remember that. Make sure you're not hurting any sensors or anything. So we're good there. You don't trust one of these only, get two and put some nails there and that works better for you. But like I said, I've done this many times, it's not gonna break. So under, and I'm gonna tell you what bolts to remove. Okay guys, so we're under the truck. We're gonna remove this shield here, a size 10 bolt there. Then another one here, you remove those, and once you remove those, it's gonna show you those bolts there, you guys can see it. But we need to unbolt those because those are the ones that are holding their rack and pinion to the frame. Okay, so I'm gonna do that. Okay guys, we're gonna those four bolts here hold the support for the engine. Then we have over here, it's a size 14 bolt. There's another one on the other side, and then I believe this is a 19 also. It holds the rack and pinion. See, it ends there, and then you're gonna have to come to the other side about here, and this one is gonna have another one right there. But this one you're gonna have to grab it from here, from the back or the top. So the first thing we're gonna do here is on the pressure line for the power stream, we're gonna remove those little brackets here. It has one there, and then this one here, they're held by a size 10 bolt on this side. I'm gonna remove it so I can wiggle it and get to the bolt right there. Hopefully you guys can see it right there. Get to this bolt right here. This nut is welded to the frame, so it has to come up from the top. But like I said, the pressure line for the power steering pump is on the way, so you need to remove this little clip that holds it. Okay, so I'm gonna remove this. Like I said, it's a size 10 bolt here. Remove it with a 1/4-inch ratchet. Okay, I'm gonna do that. Okay guys, so I removed the bolt, the clips that hold the pressure hose for the power steering pump. See where my ratchet is? That's the bolt that you need to get, and this one here in the front. So that one right here. So I'm gonna remove those bolts. Okay, I'm gonna remove those that hold the mount. They're size 14. And then I believe this is a 19. So let me get the socket.
Yeah.
Okay, now we're gonna remove this. It's a size 17. Sometimes you need to put a wrench there and hold it with the wrench. So hopefully that's not gonna happen right now. It wasn't that bad. So here's now let's put them together so we know where it goes. And now guys, we have to go to the other side and get the other bolt that's here. See, we can get it from the other side. If not, you have to struggle it through here. It's a 14 or 12, I believe it's a 14, so I'm gonna do that guys. Okay guys, you come to the back where the sway bar is. There's the other bolt. Just like I said, it has a nut on the other side, and sometimes you need to hold the nut with the wrench to remove it. So I'm gonna do that guys, but I'll let you guys know which bolt I'm talking about. It's right by the big bolt for the frame. So I'm gonna do that guys.